Ciao a tutti, my name is Stefano and today I'm super excited because I'm starting a new series of video on 5 minutes editing in Darktable, where I take, for example, a photo like this one and I edit it to the next level. And please do leave a comment to say if you like this editing and also what you learn from this video, because if there is nothing you have learned from this video, what's the point for me to do actually a video? And another thing, from next Thursday, I'm gonna post new videos on Australia, which is the place where I live. It's gonna be so much fun. You should watch it, definitely. Okay, let's get straight into the interface of Darktable. Here I am in the interface of Darktable with this photo I made in the Mornington Peninsula in Port C, Oceanside. Beautiful place, by the way, if you're around Melbourne. Now, in this editing, I'm gonna use the OSC editing process, which means basically I first work on the overall photo, then I edit my photo to move attention more into the subject, and finally, I'm gonna control the colors. But let's start with the first module that I want to use here, which is the exposure module, and the reason being is a bit too dark. This is a long exposure photo I did with 25 seconds and aperture of f9. So let's go into the exposure module and add a tiny bit, maybe 0.5 or a little bit more. And this is the first module I want to use just to bright up the photo. But the second module is to add the local contrast, because this part of the photo there's not much contrast, and this is due mostly to the fact that I use 25 second exposure. I don't want to increase the contrast into the water or into the clouds. I just want to work on my subject, which is the central part of this photo. So now let's add the local contrast. I add a tiny bit. Now concentrate your attention on this part of the photo, because we're gonna exclude everything else with the parametric mask. So that's what I want to do. You see that if I leave a local contrast just also into the water, I don't get a nice long exposure feeling into this water. So what I do in this case, I just work on the local contrast on the B channel. Why the B channel? Because you want to exclude the application of a filter into the blue part of this photo. So I'm just decreasing that, but in order to be sure what I'm doing, I actually activate the mask. You see that in this case, I'm already excluding the sea and also part of the clouds. I'm gonna refine a little bit more here, and that's pretty much it. That's what I want the local contrast to work on. I want also to exclude the foreground here, just because I wanted to have it a nice smooth sort of blurry foreground. I don't want contrast here, but that's easy to do because you get a gradient only up to here, and maybe I also curve it a little bit. Yeah, that's pretty much it. You see a before and after of a local contrast, before and after. Beautiful. I want to add also a comment on what I'm doing for each module. So local contrast, control and the left click, and I say beach and coast. At least I know what I'm using the module for. I'm pretty happy now with the overall photo. What I want to do is to use modules to give more attention to my subject, which is this central part of my photo. And the first module I want to add is the vignetting module. So I go here and I like it to be a little bit more sort of oval in this way. And you see that I'm darkening basically the upper part of the sky to draw more of the interest into the subject. And the same also for the bottom part, which is my foreground. I want really the eye to go into the brightest part of the photo. I'm pretty happy with the vignetting as it is, very straightforward. So I'm gonna close this one. Now what I want to do here is to dodge a little bit of a line into the beach to take more of attention into this life-saving club of the beach. And I'm gonna also dodge a little bit more here around. And I have a preset that does already that, and it's in the exposure module. So I'm gonna create a new instance of that, which I call in this case control dodge, and I'm gonna do a preset +1. And this is a preset that I have already into my presets that you can download for free, and I'm gonna put a link into the video description, easy. So I'm gonna take now a brush and I'm gonna paint a little bit of a line, a little bit bigger maybe, into the beach. And then I'm gonna take also the circle to dodge a little bit here and there. you see that the attention goes more and more into this part of the photo. Let's see before and after. Now that I finish with the overall and the subject, I'm gonna move to controlling the colors, especially these beautiful blue colors of the sea, and also the sand and the coast, the green, nice green. And to do that, I'm gonna use the Velvia module. And I'm gonna increase the Velvia color a little bit. But you see that when you increase, you make a nice statement of the beach, but probably here we're going a little bit overboard. So I'm gonna use two Velvia modules, one to control the color here of the beach and another one to control the colors of the sky and the sea. So on the first instance, I'm gonna call you beach and coast, and I'm gonna use the same mask that I actually use for the local contrast, which is only this area here, you remember? And now that I'm happy with the colors on the beach and the coast, I'm gonna use again the Velvia module to work on the water. So I'm gonna create a new instance here of the Velvia, and I'm gonna call this instance sea and sky, and I'm gonna increase a little bit of strength. Just focus on these colors here and not the color of the beach, because I'm gonna use a parametric mask to work just on the blue colors, and a little bit less here. I need to exclude this area. To do that, I go into the luminescence. And that's pretty much it. You see how I'm applying only to this part of the sky and the sea my Velvia. You see it before and after. Perfect. So I'm gonna move to the last module I want to use for this photo, which is the colorize module, to add a little bit of orangish into the sky. You can probably do the same with the color balance. I'm just like the colorize module because it gives me more flexibility. So let's do this in the colorize module. I add a little bit of a red here. So I activate the colorize, but I'm gonna use a parametric mask. I'm gonna put a nice gradient filter here to apply it only on the sky. And now with the parametric mask, I'm gonna apply these changes only to the sky and only to the brightest part of the sky. Obviously I don't want all of these red, so I'm gonna work on the opacity down just to give a nice reddish sunset there in the background. You see, from nothing you tend to increase as much as you like, as much as you prefer. Perfect. And that's all of editing I want to do on this photo. So let me do first a snapshot, and now that's how we started and that's how we finish, before and after. I really like the way we edited this photo, because it takes out all of the nice colors of the coast, of the beach. There is also the beautiful here life saving club, which takes the attention, being so bright. Long exposure, we had this sky and sea with beautiful colors. So I think we had all we could do with this photo. So I think we really took out the best part of this beautiful place in the Moreton Peninsula. I hope I made it in 5 minutes. Fingers crossed I did. I'm gonna see the editing. And of course I suggest to subscribe to the channel if you want to see other editing of landscape photos, a street photo, any kind of photo. I usually love to do. And I see you in the next video. Ciao, ciao.